Hey guys, welcome back. I just almost said welcome back to another vlog. It is not a vlog, it is not a tutorial. This is something totally different and I'm super pumped for it. I kinda had this idea in my head. It is not a new idea. It is something that other creators are already doing, especially makeup creators and obviously some nail creators, but I wanna do a will I buy it? So we are going to talk about the newer releases and whether or not it's something that I'm going to put my money into or whether I think I'm just gonna pass. The opinions are all my own. Everything that I'm talking about, nothing has been gifted. I keep looking over here and it's because I am actually using my picture camera to film with today because I had full intentions on filming and then I left my vlogging camera 1 and 2 at home and this one is flashing me some stuff over here. I think it has to do with the memory card. Not sure, don't know what it means. Not sure if I need to pay attention to it. We're just gonna carry on. We may end up finishing this on the old iPhone, but that's okay too. So let's get started. The first thing I have that I wanted to talk about, let's start with Apres. Apres has the tips, the Gel-X tips that I love. You guys know that if you've been here any at all, but they also have this French manicure gel ombre series. So when I first seen it, I was like, yes, add to cart, yes, I need that. And the more I looked at it, the more I was like, no, actually I don't. It has a really cool angled brush on it, and I think that's really neat. It's an angled in-bottle brush, pinpoint precision for crisp, clean smile lines, dense, high-quality bristles for smoother, easier application. Angled shape can reach the corners and sweep across the curves of the French nail. Now, look, of course we all want that. Necessary? I don't know. And I looked at the colors, and guys, the colors are beautiful. They have like, I don't know how many different ombre versions. So what they mean by ombre is 5 different colors that are corresponding. Love that idea. But again, I have a really big collection of colors. So do I need 5 blues with an angled brush when I have probably 8 blues that are already kind of know how to work? So that's gonna be a pass from me, although I do think it's a wicked idea and I do really like where they were going with it, what they were trying to do. That being said, I have never used the Apres gel, so I can't speak on it, but I'm sure it's okay. I have to say that I'm pretty sure that they seem to be a company that makes sure that things are like super cool before they put it out. Maybe not. Let me know down below if you've used it or if you plan on buying it. I do think it's a cool concept. It's just not gonna be for me this time. So next up on the list is C&D. So, okay. So the C&D new collection is called C&D Party Ready, hashtag C&D Party Ready. They say, tell us which shade you are loving. So there is glitter sneakers, signature lipstick, silk slip dress, white button down, statement earrings, and high-waisted jeans. I looked through it. That's a no from me. I'm gonna say no on that because the colors seem a little repetitive. For me, again, these are all my opinions. Like, I have a huge collection. So for me, these colors would not be something I would run out and buy. I'm also not a massive fan of their formula. It's just not right for me. The bottles are a little bit small. I don't get the applications that I want out of them. I don't love the brush. The price point isn't right for me. I just don't know what else to say about them. I know a lot of people really love C&D and I used their acrylic for years and years. I do think they're a good company. This C&D Party Ready collection, I don't think is going to be on my list of things that I need to buy. If I was going to even look at any of them, it would probably be statement earrings, but even then, probably not. So the next one on my list is going to be the Artistic Nail Design Collection. It is the Breakout Beauty Collection. It features a range of shades from subtle to smoky that are perfect for the changing weather of the fall season. Grab yours now. This collection, would I buy the whole collection? No, for a couple of reasons. Number one, I have colors similar to these. I think if you didn't have a huge collection and you were really looking to up your fall collection, I think these would be super cool. You have your dark teal or what looks like a dark teal. You have your light, your burgundy, your brownish. I really love this rosy. If anybody's had Rosy Posy, like Elegance Rosy Posy, others, I'm sure there's a bunch of others, but that's the one that comes to mind. Rosy Posy kind of looks like it might be like that. And then there's like a dark purple. I think this would be a really cool collection just to have. Like I said, especially if you don't have like a ton of colors for fall and winter, I think this would last you out. You could mix and match. Like I see like a few different color combinations going on here. I feel like they've matched them well. Whereas I think when I look at some of the other collections, I'm like, I don't know about those colors, but yeah, the artistic one, I would say spot on for you guys. Good job. Next on the list is going to be the Beanie Beauty Box Amber Collection for fall. Its official launch date was October 23rd, so this has been out for a minute. But I kind of like this one as well, as far as the color scheme goes. As far as the mix goes, I do kind of like them. They're a bit light though. They are a bit light. Yeah, they're a bit on the light side. However, I think they would be a really nice add-on as far as colors go. And the reason why I wouldn't say no to this, I wouldn't probably rush out and grab it, but the reason why it would be kind of on my list would be it has a medium green that is on the light side. It has that medium rose. It has that orange color that I feel like everybody's after that you can never nail. And it has the mustard yellow that, you know, if mustard yellow has to be a nice color, then that is a nice version of it. So I don't think I would buy the entire collection, although the blue is pretty and the white, they're just things that I have a lot of. The other four colors I do think are kind of nice. I think I would probably maybe not go out and get the whole collection, but I would get those few. You guys let me know if you want me to do this type of thing, if you want me to look at certain brands. Let me know which colors or which collections you would like me to look into. Again, these opinions are all of my own, but I do think sometimes it's nice to find one place that just kind of has all of the things you need. I would never convince you not to purchase something just because I don't feel like it's going to be an addition to my collection. It doesn't mean it wouldn't be a perfect addiction. Addition to yours. This whole camera thing, it's really throwing me off. If you like this video, please hit the like button and comment and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.